now let's talk about more more serious situations when it comes to maybe being born with a birthmark that is difficult to handle, which is something called hemangioma, correct?
Yes, there's two main red birthmarks. One is a hemangioma and one is a port wine birthmark.
All right, we have pictures of a baby born with hemangioma. Let's take that right now. And doctor, talk about the importance of removing these and look at the difference.
I know, aren't they beautiful?
Oh my goodness.
Love our little kiddos. So hemangiomas are very common. About 20% of the population can have them somewhere on their body.
What exactly are they, if I may ask?
They're tumors of blood vessels, actually.
Got it.
So and what's interesting, and I don't want to get too geeky on you, is the only parts of the human body is the woman's placenta, and hemangiomas have certain receptors. So we think somehow it came from the woman's placenta.
Okay.
But we see it more in twins, we see it more in young baby girls, and we see it more in premature infants. But hemangiomas, you know, you might have one anywhere on the body. And the old theory, when I was in medical school many years ago, mm-hmm. they said, oh, they'll go away. But the truth is they don't go away. They involute, but they can leave scars and residual areas there that don't look good at all. The other problem is sometimes in certain locations on the eye area, it can cause problems with vision. If it's in the neck area, they can have breathing problems. So they're not all benign. And the lasers are magical with these. You can do two or three laser treatments and they go completely away.
Now, how do you do that with a baby? Obviously, yeah. I'm going to assume here, I'm no doctor, but you don't put them under, right?
We don't. Actually, the FDA has issued warnings against general anesthesia unless you absolutely have to medically, because it can damage development,
of
unfortunately.
Course. So a bit so challenging, if you will?
It's really not. Actually, no. These little babies, they don't have much feeling. And I think I learned this on PBS, actually. You know, teeth come through bones, and so baby's nervous system is the last to develop. As a matter of fact, unfortunately, a lot of our nervous system doesn't develop until we're adults, until we're like 24, the good thinking pathway of our young teenagers and adults. But so they really don't have good pain fiber pathways. And when we treat babies, it's real easy. The parents are in the room. It takes about 3 to 10 seconds to do this.
That's it.
That's it.